in the Pledge of Allegiance. Ready? Begin.
ASD hosted a silent auction, and Mrs. Montadini purchased all the offices for $200. Our new mascot has been designed specifically for RHS, and it will be unveiled next school year in August. The parking space auction was done, and ASD raised $825. Senior class took a trip to Universal on April 27th. Senior sunset is on May 26th. All the members are invited. Grad night is on May 27th. Senior award night is tomorrow. And yearbook distribution party is on Friday.
Our mathlete teams went for competition this week. Sixth was today, Tuesday. Seventh was today, and eighth is tomorrow. This Friday, May 20th, is our sports banquet. Also, this Friday, we are starting practice for promotion. May 23rd is our academic awards banquet. Tuesday, May 24th, is the 8th grader trip to Six Flags. 8th grade promotion is June 1st, and that's it.
Welcome, everybody, to our showcase night for Westpark. Thank you, parents. For coming out, staff members coming out, board, everybody for coming out. We have a great showcase for you guys. These are just some of the great highlights that we've had on here. Westpark has had an amazing year this year. If you also look around the cafeteria, each grade level got a chance to do some artwork. So before you leave, check out the great artwork that these students have done for you. I'm not going to take a lot of your night because a lot of this belongs to our students, and our students will be showcasing some amazing things. The first person that we have up here is going to be Miss Anna Howell. And Miss Anna Howell was Westpark's runner-up for the National Challenge for Future Chef. So we'll be telling you'll get passed out and you can eat and be entertained.
Thank you.
Oh, and Anna wanted to show off the great trophy she got, so you want to hold it up? So we had a great turnout for Future Chefs. We had five students compete, five students from each school, and one person from Mr. Torres' school, Rosamond Elementary, actually got first place for frozen banana?
Yeah, dipped in chocolate.
So yeah, they did an awesome job. Like, and the person that was instrumental in getting this together is Mr. Ben Montgomery from Sedesco. Stand up, Ben. Oh, there's almonds in it, so if you're allergic to almonds, just FYI.
Or take a bite.
It'll be next to piece for me, so. Thank you, Adam. All right, so next we have on the list is Ms. Selby, fifth grade. Come on up. She was our science fair teacher coordinator this year. She's going to talk a little bit about the science fair.
Hi,
my two assistants coming with me. Okay, so this year we did science fair. We had 115 students participate and turn in boards. We ended up with three winners from our school's science fair, and all three of those winners got to go to the county fair in Bakersfield. And both Alexi and Tyler are some of our winners from the county fair. So each student that participated created an experiment with a question, and then they had to make a prediction or a hypothesis, and then they listed their materials and procedures, analyzed their results from their experiment, and then wrote up their conclusions on these nice boards. So Alexi Finch won honorable mention at the county science fair in food science, and Tyler won second place in electricity at the science fair. And both of them are going to tell you a little bit about it.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Tyler Thompson, and I'm a fourth grade student here at Westpark Elementary School. At the Kern County Science Fair, I placed second for electricity. My project was testing batteries, which batteries would last the longest because my Xbox One controller won't work without them. And that is a scary thought. What I found was that you do get what you pay for, because the most expensive battery was the Duracell Quantum, and it lasted the longest, which means plenty of gaming time for me, yay! Even though the Duracell Quantum lasted the longest, they were not the most cost effective, which makes my mom and dad cringe. But not to worry, I did find that the Kirkland batteries were the most cost effective for the amount of time they lasted. A happy ending for me and my parents' bank account. Thank you.
I'm Alexi Finch. I'm a fifth grade student at Westpark Elementary School. The thing I liked most about the science fair was going to Bakersfield to present my project and getting to see the huge variety of projects that the other kids did. I learned that when water is hot, the rate of dispersion is much higher.
And thank you, that's my answer.
Yes, so we have a PowerPoint later on tonight. It's going to have some pictures of the science fair. So great job to all the students that participated. The next person we have is Ms. Collins. Ms. Collins is our kindergarten teacher, and she's also the Westpark Elementary coordinator for ballroom program for youth.
Thank you. So I'm Jenny Collins. I teach kindergarten, and I also teach a ballroom dance class here at Westpark. And this is actually my sixth year of teaching ballroom dance here at Westpark after school. It's a program that's actually existed for about 10 years, and it ranges from fifth grade to high school students now. And here at Westpark, we've done fifth grade for the last 6 years, and then the last 2 years, I added fourth graders. So this year, we had 105 students that signed up and started dance with us. And then by the time we got to competition, we still had about 65 students who were with us and had come to practice and wanted to go to competition with us. We competed in March, and so tonight we have some of our finalists and semifinalists here to do our three ballroom dances, which are Foxtrot, East Coast Swing, and Merengue. And then we have a fun extra dance that we like to do. So we'd like to show you.
Thank you. Fly me to the moon. Let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, baby, kiss me. Fill my heart with song and let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. In other words, I love you.
Africa, time me up, 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 me
going, and students, great job. That's amazing. I also wanted to mention to you guys also that Mrs. Wilson is sorry that she couldn't attend tonight for you guys. I know she was super excited. She keeps texting me how everything's going. So I want to know that everything went well tonight. So you guys make sure you tell her the same thing, all right? Next up, we have Miss Eubanks' class. Miss Eubanks is a first grade teacher, and she's going to have a student do a soloist from her play that they've been performing for the last 3 days.
Thank you, Mr. Meza. Welcome to Westpark. One of my passions, even though I'm a first grade teacher, is drama. And every year, I'm lucky enough, I guess you could say, to perform a play with my class. The play we did this week was called Life Cycles, and it really summed up a lot of the biological things we learned this year. And I have two of my soloists that are going to come and sing a solo for you. So, Mia Nagel and Mary Jane Reyes, go ahead and head up stage, please. Biologists, how can you tell what kind of offspring a plant or animal will have?
That's an easy one. You're talking about certain characteristics?
Did a fabulous job, so thank you.
All right, for the last portion of this showcase is, I asked teachers to send me pictures of the entire year. We got so many of them that when I started putting the PowerPoint together, it turned out to an hour. So I figured I couldn't keep you here for an hour, so I narrowed it down to 14 minutes. But it's things that they've done for the entire year. These students are so amazing, and it's interesting to see what they're capable of when we don't think they're able to do certain things, and we show them the way as parents and educators. They thrive on that, and then they present to you a side that you've never seen before, and you run with that side to help them achieve their individual achievement. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to present a PowerPoint for you guys with just some of the highlights of this year, okay?
I'm in the sun, I'm on. I'm
promotion that we were doing this year is making sure that we go above beyond for our students, and our students being fearless and taking chances on different things with education. Halloween also, Mrs. Notterman, I know you guys won, but I saw it put the pictures in there. BMX, Jethawks, the Ned Show, which is an anti-bullying program, and also Gold Ribbon. And Mr. Carr, come on up here real quick. So Mr. Carr is our third grade teacher. Mr. Carr got the award this year, the honor of representing our school as Teacher of the Year. Can you tell us a little bit about what, how that came to be and like what happened over at Bakersfield?
Stood in a long line of teachers, and it was really cool. They presented us with the awards and a lot of commendations from congressmen and senators from California and the United States Congress. It was pretty cool. Got a bundle of really neat stuff that makes you feel special. Makes you feel really humble at the same time, because it's like there's so many other people out here that work just as hard, but it's nice to be recognized. So I accept it on behalf of all of us, because we all do it. We're all doing it.
Thank you. I want to stress again, parents, thank you for investing in your child's time. Their education is important. If it's important to you, it's going to be important to them. Teachers, thank you for being their parents while they're at school. I know our number one thing in the district is safety first, and that's what you parents make sure that you drop off your kids, and when you get them back, they're safe and sound. So we thank you for trusting us with your kids. And that concludes our Westpark Elementary showcase. So thank you everyone for coming out. Appreciate it.
So we thought it would be a good opportunity, since we're at Westpark, to talk a little bit about next year's education at the elementary school level. And this plan was put together by all of our staff, but was kind of scribed and put together through Dan Wexler, Leanne Hargis, and myself. Dan is our IT director. Leanne Hargis, obviously, our associate superintendent of education. So why don't we go ahead to the next group. So we start here 4 years ago when I started. We started to look at what we were educating, what we were teaching, and how we were going about it. So one of the things we decided that we were going to do was we were going to start looking at the whole child education, which is something that we thought was very, very needed in our district. Unfortunately, you know, there are various great things of being in a small town and a little bit of isolation, getting to know your neighbor, being a part of a community where you feel like you make a difference. But some of the things that also come along with being a small town is we don't have certain services here for our children, for ourselves, we decided that since we really don't have a city government to go to, we would take the role of trying to help the whole child, and not just on the educational level, but obviously we know that safety is first, but on the social level, physical level, health level, support the child emotionally and intellectually. So campus safety among students has always been our number one goal. It was the first goal that we wrote on my famous whiteboard in my office. It is very important that we create a safe environment. Our parents, all parents know that the most important thing with their children is that they're safe. We may get angry at them, we may punish them, but in the end, all we really care is they're safe. And while we have them, while we have the fiduciary responsibility of those children, our number one goal is to keep them safe at all times. Then we started to look at some other things. School safety was the first thing. The second thing we thought of was what else is lacking for our school. And the first thing we decided to do was to go out to the community, and we realized that one of the best things that we could do is offer free meals to everybody. So that was the next thing that we did. This was back in 2013. So what are we going to do next year? So along with the changes that we have been making, next year, some of the big changes that we're making is that each elementary school will have an academic and social counselor. That's two separate counselors. One will be an academic counselor, credentialed academic counselor, and then we will have a licensed social behavioral counselor also. And this way, whatever the roadblock that the child is experiencing to get the best education possible, we will be able to use the counselor to put together the parents, the students, administrators, and teachers, and give them the support that they need. We're going to continue to invest in our after-school enrichment. Next year, our focus will be a lot on academics, but we also will hope to expand to bring music to the after-school program and some more physical activities. We hope to bring some sports to the elementary school program, as well as support. I know we have the choir going and the dance, and we hope to bring a lot of that to the after-school programs. And if you've seen our secondary schools, their after-school programs are massive, and we hope to bring all those things here to the elementary school. And we already talked about AVID, but I think what needs to be said about AVID is that for the first time, along with Common Core, we are really trying to vertically articulate a child looking forward all the way into college, where you have your college field trips, as well as helping them organize their thoughts, their notes, and organize how they're going to go about being successful in school and the next year. This is something I'm very, very proud of. Ms. Hargis and I got together and we talked about the environment and how important early childhood education is, and that there wasn't a lot out there for parents to get free public education in pre-K as well as TK. So we expanded our TK program and we now have 160 pre-K students in the district. And just for your own information, it looks like in the next year will be the last year that California State will be funding TK. So we ourselves fund pre-K ourselves. We don't get any funding from the state. And TK is funded through the state. But it looks like they're going to be dropping the TK funding and that we will be doing TK and pre-K our own funding, but we are applying for grants to continue it. But we feel that pre-K and TK child education, preparing a child for school socially, intellectually, and behaviorally is very, very important. The two largest preschool educations in Roseman, one was the Wayside Chapel, which their preschool is now closed, and the county Head Start program. And next year will be the last year that Head Start will be available. The county will be closing that program down and having districts take over any type of Head Start program. Here's some growth that we see right away in our third, fourth, and fifth grade. We see a massive improvement in our scoring of our state testing in third grade and fifth grade. And although slight, there is an improvement in our fourth grade. And this is for our ELA, which is our English language. And we see the same improvement this year in math. We scored much higher in math in third, fourth, and fifth grade. So some of the things that we're going to be doing is we're going to be doing some data and assessments throughout the year, and this is going to be done through a program called STAR, STAR Reading, Math, and STAR Early Literacy. This will allow teachers to learn exactly how fast the kids are absorbing information, as well as know where they need to reteach, differentiate teaching, and also go back and make sure that they're getting the basis of the teaching plan. And blended learning is taking our face-to-face learning with our teacher and blending it also with online and technology. And so here's what we're going to be, when we come back in August, this is what's going to be awaiting the students. Fifth graders will have Chromebooks 101, and they will be taking those home. So they will have their own personal laptop, all fifth graders. They will have textbooks in hardcover, but they will also have textbooks on the laptop itself, as well as other learning programs. And every fifth grader will have a 101 device. Every fourth grader will have a 101 device. Also, same thing, Chromebooks, except those books will not be going home. Those books will remain in the classroom. and be used by a teacher in the classroom. We are seeing how that goes, and maybe the second semester will allow them to take it home, but we haven't decided yet. That's going to be up to the school and the teachers. And in third grade, each classroom will have 7 Chromebooks, and there will be a cart that will go amongst the third grade classes that will have 24 additional Chromebooks on it. So at any one time, a class can have all Chromebooks, or they can work just with the 7 in their classroom. In the early education, in kindergarten through second grade, and that includes pre-K and TK, we will be having 6 iPads in each room, and we will have a cart per grade level, which by the end of the second semester, we will add a cart, so there will be 2 carts per grade level in preschool through second grade. And those will be iPads, and those will also be fully operational with learning technology as well as learning software. We just adopted our new curriculum, which is McGraw-Hill, and this is approved by the state. We had to wait until they finally approved an English Arts, arts program with the Common Core, and we just adopted McGraw-Hill, California Wonders program. And we are going to be focusing on literacy next year. We believe literacy is the foundation of all student achievement. We will be introducing an overdrive digital library. We will continue to add to our print book collection in our library. Along with the overdrive digital library, we will be having at each elementary school, we will have 50 Chromebooks that will be able to be checked out by parents to bring home so their children can work on them. We will be using the Accelerated Reader Program. We use that now. We'll continue to do that. And then we're going to start a program called Drop Everything and Read. And Drop Everything and Read is kind of like a fire drill, except instead of going outside with that fire drill, you drop everything and you read the book that you are working on currently. And for intervention or to help our readers, we currently are using, and in fact, this is one of the reasons that Westpark won their Golden Ribbon Award, we will be using the Read 180 iRead and System 44 programs for our reading intervention and to help our readers that are reading below grade level to bring them up to the proper grade level. Hello. And also, all of our Chromebooks will have Google's apps for education along with our iPads. And this will allow all our students to enhance their communication and collaboration with each other skills with Google Docs, critical thinking programs, and creativity. And we have our subscription Google Apps, so all of the Google Apps educational software is available to us. For our math, we are currently using McGraw-Hill, My Math, and to supplement that, we will be continue using our IXL program, and we feel it's been very successful this year, and we'll continue to use it. Other elements you saw in your presentation, we have Project Lead the Way. We are looking at adding an additional Project Lead the Way teacher, so there will be one at each elementary school. We're going to be continuing with our keyboarding program, which this year will be Typing Club. And then we'll also be continually using Math Facts, which is a game type Math Facts for our kids to learn. New program for our faculty. All of these are new for our faculty, but go ahead. So one of the things we're doing is we're adding paraeducators to each grade level. So there'll be an additional paraeducator at each grade level, as well as paraeducators for the PE classes. And what this will do by adding paraeducators to the PE classes, it'll allow the teachers, instead of working with the physical education teachers, will allow the paraeducators, and that will actually give 100 additional minutes per week for our teachers for planning. And then we have also added to our teachers' ability to, instead of just in the beginning of the year, actually doing pacing guides, we're actually doing interactive curriculum mapping also. And then, of course, we're going to be continuing with our professional development. We will be starting our professional development actually at the end of July to help our teachers adapt to the new things that are coming and train them, and that'll be the first 2 weeks before we actually start school. And then throughout the year, Wednesdays, minimum day Wednesdays, they'll be able to collaborate as well as be trained. And that 2 days during the year, which we did this year that went over very well, we reserve 2 days a year for non-student days where teachers come in for a full day of training in different workshops that we have. And our teachers themselves will have one-on-one devices. They already have their laptops, but we're going to make sure that they take them home over the summer, and that way it's available for them to work on whatever they need to work on over the summer. And that is it. So that's what's coming next year. There'll be some additional things, but we met with our teachers, and they seem pretty happy with what's coming, and we're real excited that we can start bringing everything that we're doing at the middle school and the high school down to the elementary school.
Banana bread, that would just rock. Congratulations to the science fair projects. They looked absolutely wonderful. I think I need to borrow one of those dance students so I can learn how to dance. I'm sure Mrs. Starkey would appreciate me knowing how to dance. So if any of you parents want to give up for maybe a couple weekends, so I can take Anna. Okay, thank you, buddy, for throwing her under the bus, you know? That's awesome. That's awesome. I appreciate that. Thank you very much. Mrs. Starkey will appreciate me knowing how to dance, for sure. Miss Eubanks, that was awesome singing soloists. The singers, they did awesome in, up here, especially in front of us. I mean, that's, I don't know, just sitting here is pretty intimidating. It's a nice video presentation, Mr. Mesa. I'd like the full version. I can get a, burn a copy, full version, I'd like to see it. And congratulations, Mr. Carr, being Teacher of the Year. That's absolutely wonderful. So not only do I represent our board, but I also was elected by our board to represent us as a CSDA delegate up in Sacramento. And we just had a delegate assembly over this last weekend where all the delegates met and we discussed issues in our local areas as well as in our counties and in the state. So one of the main things that we did over Friday and Saturday was we voted to support positions on four statewide ballot measures. We are gonna be supporting the California Children's Education and Healthcare Act of 2016, which is going to be extending Proposition 30 for 12 years, which could generate $4 billion for K-12 education. We're also gonna be supporting the Kindergarten through Community College Public Education Facilities Bond Act of 2016, and it proposes $7 billion for K-12, $3 billion for new facilities construction, $3 billion for modernization, and $50 million for charter and career technical education. We're also going to be supporting the California Healthcare Research and Prevention Tobacco Tax Act of 2016, which this tax is going to be increasing programs from the funds to lead fewer young people becoming addicted to tobacco products and electronic cigarettes. We're also going to be supporting the California Education for Global Economy Initiative, which is going to ensure that learning English and other languages in public schools remains an integral part of student success. So those are some of the things that we're going to be supporting on this coming election. That's not helpful. That's the timer, so I'm not supposed to talk more, obviously. So it was very disappointing to hear that the ASB advisor could not follow the ASB constitution for the elections at RHS yesterday. But what was worse was it was extremely disappointing that when given the information well in advance, the RHS administration allowed the ASB advisor to run the elections the way she wanted and not how the students voted into their constitution. Thank you all for coming out tonight.
Congratulations, and job well done to our science folks. Anna will be teaching dance and cooking. That's what I mean. Keeping that thread. And Mrs. Collins, what a great job you've done with the dancing. I got to be a part of that. Assistant next to you, she did a great job. Keep all the little people in lines. And I didn't understand when a couple of the kids, they won so they didn't have to dance, and the other kids didn't. And I realized, oh, that's a free pass because you've done so well. So, and then I got to hand out ribbons, so that was really neat. And let me say this, there's a lot of kids there, you know, we've hit on, not every kid's going to be an athlete, or not every kid's going to be in the band, or maybe not every kid's going to be the 4.0. But these kids that won these ribbons. It was amazing. We were so happy. And so when we have stuff like this, we're, you know, the round hole and the square peg, and it was really, really neat, you know. So, you know, the arts are so, so important, and it's nice to know that at every level we have great teams of whatever. And it's truly amazing. So being a part of that, being a part of all of this, and as my friend Mr. Quellman said, this can't be Rosamond. We don't do this in Rosamond. And everybody here has been a part of that. I would like to thank and congratulate Mr. Carr. What an amazing man. I think Mr. Carr many, many years ago in another outfit, let's just say, but we'll leave it with that. And then next to Mr. Carr is Mrs. Carr, who I've heard rocks the Rosamond High School yearbook. I mean, it's just amazing. Just amazing. So we'll see that on Friday. So that's pretty amazing. And then Mr. Spielberg Meza over here. And it's amazing. It really has. You know, the things that we've done and we continue to do here is just mind-blowing at times. It really is, from everything and anything. And so I would like to thank everybody here, parents, teachers, educators, administration. It's just fantastic.
Thank everybody for coming. I actually had the pleasure of being a judge at the cook-off when they were doing the baking and cooking and everything. It was just amazing. The food these kids made that day was great. I wanted to doggy bag it all up and take it home with me. Who wouldn't let me? And they said that banana bread is excellent tonight. The kids, the dancing, I really enjoy dancing, so watching them do that was just amazing. They were really good, and I never thought we could get fourth graders to dance.
Fourth grade boys.
And the fourth grade girls. Fourth grade boys. It's amazing to see everybody's been doing, and the science fair, I've got to participate a couple times in being a judge for that. It seems like the kids just keep getting smarter, even smaller and smarter. They're just, I'm amazed every time I come and participate with some of the kids. So thank you everybody for doing such a great job. And all our support staff that gives us the ability to be able to do what we've been able to do with the kids.
I've been doing this for 20 too many years. I remember probably about 10 or 12 years ago making one of my grandstands in front of the board and talking about the tremendous opportunity we have in this district. Because, echoing what Mr. Weinstein said a little bit earlier tonight, having a district of this size, being somewhat isolated, giving us almost complete autonomy and control, because we're so far away from the Kern County office. And we're certainly not part of, you know, the Antelope Valley with LA County.
Thank goodness.
That we're able to take advantage of that opportunity and have such control that we can achieve fantastic things. I'm sorry to say it's been 10 or 12 years since I made that presentation, and now it is finally coming to reality. And that's because of the board and the administration, the teachers, the support staff, everybody that's involved. And working together, which will be a part of what I've got to present tonight. But something I hadn't prepared but came to mind as you were talking again tonight, Mr. Otis, about that. Disappointed that Mrs. Kirk is not here tonight because I've spent the last 2 days with our middle school math leads and get to do the same thing again tomorrow. And I wanted to make sure she was aware that her granddaughter, Hannah Kirk, had the third highest score of more than 200 students at the Palmdale Math League tournament today and took third place overall. That was an exceptional job by her granddaughter, and so I wanted to let her know that in public, and she's not here. But to the RTA stuff, I wanted to let you know also that I am very pleased to report tonight that the Rosamond Teachers Association and the Southern Kern Unified School District have put together the framework for a tentative agreement of our contract. It is a 3-year agreement that includes a variety of changes in language that better define many current practices and procedures that are already in place. The new agreement also lowers class sizes, which goes directly in hand-in-hand with what Mrs. Hargis and Mr. Weinstein were presenting tonight. It lowers class sizes across the board in classes from preschool through the 12th grade. In grades pre-K through the 3rd grade, classes will be lowered to 24 students in 2 years so that those teachers can better meet the needs of all students. And this is where we teach our students to read, because lower class, and so lower class sizes at these grade levels are absolutely essential. And that was a proposal by the district, which we greatly appreciate. Of course, the contract offers moderate yet significant salary increases that help support the teaching staff as they continue to work harder than ever. There is even help for the district in our plan that has put in place a plan that will allow the district to contain and better budget for the constant increasing health care benefit costs. So we're glad to help the district out in that area as well. So 6 weeks ago, I told the board that I look forward to positive, collaborative, and beneficial contract negotiations, and that is exactly what happened. We reached our agreement in just 2 bargaining sessions, and that's absolutely unheard of. I want to thank Mr. Weinstein and his staff for their preparation and diligence in reaching an agreement. Thank you also to Mr. Starkey for sitting in on the meetings. It showed how the board supports the district administration and its commitment to help provide the teachers with a good and fair bargaining agreement. And I know Mr. Starkey represented the entire board. And lastly, I want to thank the members of my negotiations team, Terry Goodman, Sandy Leeway, John Warfield, and Sarah Varela. I greatly appreciate everyone's time and efforts in this endeavor, and thank you for the agreement.
Thank you.